You see a lot of sisters go, you mess with this kind of girl and that kind of girl, that shit exotic. That shit look a lot different than the shit you see in the neighborhood all the time. That shit looked like it came off a boat. That's 50 Cent. What do you ladies think about him capping? Actually, you know, having a liking to women who are perceived as more exotic.
You can go and go first if you like.
He just has such fuckboy tendencies. Do you know what I mean?
Okay.
He's just like, when I read that, I was like, really? You would say that because you don't want anyone to challenge you or talk to you. You want somebody to sit over there and be a pretty little dog that you can just pay, right? Can't handle a black woman, can you?
I'm going to say something. 50 Cent is a powerful black man. And we look up to him in a lot of different ways as a businessman. You are leading a lot of black men, whether you like it or not. We need you. Like, we need you to love on us. So to do that kind of allows them, it kind of leads other black men to feel that way. And this is how we keep being in predicaments where now we can't get our men to connect with us. Now there's a disconnect within our culture. We don't need that right now. We just don't need that right now. This is not the time for that.
Okay, I think y'all about to be mad with me. Look at this. What? Here's the thing. If that's his preference, that's his preference. Yeah.
Well, you right.
You know what I mean? And so that's just no different than, you know, someone saying that I love Italian men because they're more romantic or exotic looking. I want blonde hair with dark eyes or whatever. You know what I mean? However, reading into what you said, Claudia, into his statement, I think that that now is just coming from his experience of having strong black women around him and being able to say what they need to say to put him in his place. And he doesn't like that, which should be no different from any other nationality that happens. If you're dating an Asian, if you're dating a Hispanic, they still gonna give it to you. It's gonna sound different, but it's still given to you. You know, so I think it was I think he kind of worded that differently.
No. Can I just say, church finger over here. No. It was the levels of disrespect, as far as I was concerned. You know, it was just so demeaning, the statement and the whole arrogance of it all. I mean, you came from a black woman. Don't ever forget that.
The bold part is what takes me down.
I mean, that's what I don't want. You everyone has a preference. You might like them tall, slim, you know. I love six pack and smiles. Well, they did, but when he did have it. But you know what I'm saying? It's like everyone has their preference and you're entitled to that. It's just you don't have to be mean. And I think that is
both I just think that's who he is. That the way he spew out, we can say that that's his character. True?
That's true.
Now, I want to piggyback on what y'all saying. Yes, you can have your preference. And I think people got to stop penalizing people for having their preference. If he want to date girls that look like they just got off the boat, then that's on him. Fine. But do you have to, in the same sentence, say angry black women? Like whoever you want. Okay. You don't have to qualify that with dissing us. Just say, I like them exotic. Don't say but angry. The reason why you like exotic is because of us. No, the reason why you like exotic is something in you. It has nothing to do with us. Like, stop trashing us to justify your preference. We ain't mad at your preference. Some of us prefer to date you. But that don't mean you got to shit on us every chance you get. We are not that angry black woman that pissed you off that one time in ninth grade. And that's a lot of things with men. Somebody hurt their ass in 1987, and for the rest of their lives, it's fuck black women, it's this, they ain't shit, and they're bitter. Yes.
That's what he's talking about. All of that and the body language and the talking, that he don't like that. That's his preference. His preference is not to have that.
But maybe my exotic's not doing that.
His preference is actually black women, then, if you want to be real technical, because Puerto Ricans, Cubans, they're all black. They all come from
the Asian. Bring the fire, honey. They come about our neck roll, honey.
They say how angry we are, and they say white women are more docile. I remember a man by the name of Tiger Woods, and when he got caught cheating, his blonde hair, blue-eyed queen took a golf club to his car in his head. So I don't know any black woman that have done that, do you?
Yeah.
But y'all, Karen alone is very angry. Karen is the angriest woman in history.
There you go.
I ain't never seen nobody like Karen. Karen gets it popping.
We got some comments, and I think y'all want to hear these comments. Okay, let's see. Tia says, Vivica, I still can't believe you dated him. And then somebody says, black men disrespecting black women is nothing new. Teresa says, he needs to shut up and have several seats. We're in a fight of our lives, and he's coming with his foolishness. Boy, bye. Lacey Chapman says, just because you have a preference does not mean you have to put down a specific group. That's all we saying, Fit. We ain't trash. You like who you want. It's on you. But
they
like,
black anyway. They black women anyway. It's cool. So you like black women. Okay. You like black women with silky hair. Okay, dear.
You like exotic.
You know, preferences.
Black women with a tan. Yeah. Don't stand out somewhere.
Preferences. Our guy, our boy, I don't know who's friends with him, Terry Crews, is once again in the hot seat after defending his claim that one particular race of people should not be above another just because of their color of their skin. What are your thoughts?
I can feel that, but Selena, if you want to take it, roll with it, girl.
I was just gonna say, where's his wife? She's the sweetest, nicest, most conscious, loving lady I've ever met.
Yeah.
Why didn't she get him together? Take his phone. What are we doing?
So you saying that he should take the stance of Black Lives Matter, period, instead of the stance of him saying all lives matter?
All lives don't matter if black lives don't matter. That's an oxymoron. If black lives don't matter, then you can't say all lives don't matter because we're part of those lives. So that's why all lives matters is contradictory, because it's stupid. We know all lives matter. We're trying to say, yeah, piece of pie is spoiling, then the whole pie is spoiled.
Yeah, because we're bringing attention to the lack of humanity for the black people.
Yes.
That's what we're saying.
That's all we're saying. For us.
That Simon Cowell check is big.
I'm not doing this
to me. No, I'm going to do it. I got to do it. I got to do it. Because you have to know when you're like, hey, I'm with us. Don't think I'm not with us. That's what he's doing. So that's why every time he does it, I'm like,
he's trying to stay neutral is what you're saying.
No, beyond neutral. Yeah,
okay. Yeah.
Right. Are you saying that he's Steven from Django holding on to white massa like we stick? Massa, we just want your eyes. It ain't that bad. You nice to me.
Oh, you Oscar. Yes, we good. We good. They can say what they want against us, but we good.
I think he's just trying to be nice. But it
it's you know, you have to learn when, like, just stop talking. You know what I mean? Like, right. You gotta learn when to just be like, okay, it's better for me just to say nothing sometimes.
Because he also is coming off of the tail end of the Gabrielle Union.
Exactly. Step back and clap.
Right.
Don't go backwards, brother. Go forward.
Yeah.
Please. Cause, I mean, he has to remember, listen, I don't care where you go in your career. If this, your color is African-American, you are always going to have to come back home.
That's right.
Don't you ever forget that. And we got good memory. A really, really good memory.
I like all the back up. All it like we see it.
He been doing too much lately. And
walk it like you talk it. Hey.
Hopefully Terry Crews comes on back home. You know, some people are saying that he's still sucking character from white chicks. And I really want him to come on back home. I think he's a great actor. He's funny as hell. Yeah. And we need you, Terry Crews. So you're trying too hard to appease them. Worry about your people at home first. And then we can get into how they feel and how uncomfortable they are. We're going to take a quick break and get back with more of this shade fest that I'm loving tonight right here on Cocktail.
What to expect when you're expecting.
Like here?
A teenager.
Today, I'm going to show you how to teen-proof your home. First step, hide the car keys. Preferably somewhere they would never look. Challenges will come up. Be ready for them. Hi, honey.
Ready for the mom. You don't use mannequins in the mannequin challenge.
You don't have to know it all to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Well, Welcome back to Cocktails with the Queens. It's a fun show tonight, ladies. It's like,
yeah, Sanjay
Sean. Here we go. You on one tonight. I love it though. You like
you on like popcorn.
You know why, Claudia? It's because you came to visit me. You left some of your little fairy dust on me.
My shady dust.
Glass.
The shade sparkle. I love it.